going to take to scratch the surface. I am proposing, along with, I believe, Chad, that we begin this project by addressing primarily the basement portion of the facility, and that includes providing essential restroom facilities for that whole project. Right now, it is not sufficient for any particular type of use. It's just so outdated. Also down there is mechanical rooms, et cetera, that will have to be addressed at the same time. And I would also like us to consider, depending on the cost that we incur, is to begin with on the entrance floor, the removal of those metal frame entranceways and the replacement of that with nice wood frame, nice decorative windows or glass work in that, along with the appropriate lighting on the outside of the building. And I think that will be an excellent start on us being able to use that facility. I also believe that after y'all have looked at all the options that are available to you for usage of that building, that it would be appropriate to consider using that facility for home of the Downtown Development Authority, the Visitors Center, and for the home, the hometown, the
Main Street,
and the tourism visitors. Those three primarily, and then if there is space available for the Historical Society, that as y'all know, they are have obtained the old hospital, whatever that hospital name is. Pardon me?
Was it Pine something?
Mm-hmm. It's adjacent. It's the one the church has.
Bird.
So they have obtained that building, and I don't know what all their intentions are, but I think we can design this facility to be utilized by those three, possibly four, and still demonstrate some potential usage on the courtroom level, and also behind the courtroom. I think that would probably be we'll make offices out of those. All the restrooms in those areas are just not really serviceable. There can be some improvements to them, but I don't think, based on what we've looked at, being able to put the public defender in there is really realistic. Chad and I have looked at how we could shoehorn them in, and it's just not feasible with the product as it now exists. It's just not going to work. And we looked at some other potential, but this, to me, seems the most logical way to approach this. Now, I will tell you that this $2 million is only going to scratch that surface. As I said, we're going to look for future SPLOST funds in order to complete this project.
There's also an option that I've included information here, if we pursued a regional welcome center, there's a list of facilities that are designated as regional welcome centers across the state in your book. But if we do that, then that also makes hotel motel tax available for renovations, so that could help with future improvements to the building. I think the moving of tourism is vital to our downtown. think the conference center and tourism authority has done a fantastic job with the staff and the space that they have been given where they are to try to meet the needs of a welcome center, of a tourism facility, but I think the building is just really not set up for that. Whenever you have people coming in and wanting to know about your area, it's just like a lot of us have seen whenever we step into those welcome centers in other towns. You want to know a little bit about what's available, what the flavor of the community is like. You want to know where to stay, where to eat, if there's any additional festivals or opportunities to experience the community that are available. And all of those things can be brought together through Tourism and Main Street being in that facility together. And it drives traffic downtown. We've also reached out to Exit 2 because we do have a welcome center at Exit 2. And they were very excited at the possibility of you all looking at the original welcome center downtown, because it would enhance and give someone in the heart of our community, give them a place for them to send people from Exit 2 to be downtown and to see the historical part.
Is this in your area?
No. Quick question. Downtown Development Authority, Main Street City businesses.
It's what?
They're not, Main Street's separate than the city of Valdosta. They've been housed in that annex, but they're a separate entity. They're not a city department.
But let me go ahead.
I just want to know, have we, say if we go to the regional visitor information center, is it possible that BSU still could use the courtroom for mock trials or what have you? They've been asking for opportunities possibly to utilize the courtroom, and we do realize that the students downtown would help businesses downtown in that area.
I have talked to Dr. Carvajal, chairman, and I had conversation with the previous president about the usage of that facility. They had discussed having lectures there, etc., but were somewhat hesitant to actually move forward on that, I think it's fair to say. Mm-hmm. So I don't think there would be any objection if the university said we would like to utilize that facility. We have several of the high school mock trial groups that currently use some of the available courtroom space in our judicial facility. The only reason it would be a little more difficult over there is simply providing access to it, really. And once we have it so that it is available, I think that can be worked out without too much problem. So I think that there is a usage there if there is some specific interest. The conversations I had were very, very general. How would we have a lecture and so forth? But to piggyback on to what you're saying about bringing the students downtown, and many of the merchants say, we want to bring the students, we want to bring the students. Well, all of us that have been students at that level remember that our biggest concern was not going to 306 or to
Steel Magnolias,
because it was way beyond our price range, where they had cheap beer and cheap pizza is kind of where we hung out, or where we wanted to hang out. So I don't know that some of the merchants have really given as much consideration about the student body as they may think. Now that's just my opinion. They have not given me any statistics that tell me that or show me that.
The one place that did meet that price point recently closed down for lack of business. Federal Records was doing movies and hot dogs and that kind of stuff, and they weren't getting enough traffic.
So I know they're wanting customers downtown. I know they're wanting their clientele to be coming in. You've got a brewery opening up downtown. Whether or not that,
Pardon?
Next to the fire station.
Yeah, you know, that's not kind of in that couple of block area there that they maybe students or anybody else may be traveling. They are certainly hopeful of that. Now, what happens, we just have to see how we draw.
I just know the Alumni Association, they I spoke with them, they expressed the interest as well as you know, some of the staff had the issue of coming to the courthouse. And should I say having the Criminal Justice Department in particular operate inside of it, more for educational purposes as well as spreading and promoting the university. But at the end of the day, what I'm thinking is if some in conjunction with this here could open up that door so you still have it, them able to do what they want to do in the courthouse as well as even spin off one of the vendors downtown, because the vendors will come once they realize people downtown.
Well, I think if I could add to that, without getting too deep into the weeds with it, there's been several different ideas that have come to the surface about what the future use of the courthouse should be and how it should be. My feelings has always been is that it needs to be accessible to as much of the public as it possibly can be. It doesn't necessarily need to be single focused, whether that be DSU, whether it be specifically an event center, all of the different things that's been proposed usage for the facility. The key is that if there's anything downtown, that historical courthouse is the center focus of downtown Valdosta. It represents a lot of history from the standpoint of, from Lowndes County. So from my standpoint, I just felt like that it was extremely important that we preserve it, number one. I mean, that's the number one focus. But secondly is that it would be accessible to as much of the public as we can possibly make it. And by putting something, some of these different groups in here that we're talking about, and it being a central welcoming station, you might call it, is going to be huge for this community because it will grow tourism. It'll be a single focus that folks can come in, and then they can disperse down the streets of downtown Valdosta. Once they see there what's offered in these areas, then they can go specifically to different areas and different merchants. Our merchants doesn't just consist of just restaurants downtown. We have all kinds of shops, clothing shops, art shops, all kinds of different venues and things that folks can actually access if they know that they're there. And this can be a central location that will allow folks to come here and get the information that they need to know what's available downtown and then disperse in the downtown area and visit downtown Valdosta. Now, Judge McLean has made it very, very clear that you know, his desire is that the courtroom is preserved. And I agree. There are some needs for that. And I think by doing that, then you can justify that if VSU or even the mock trial groups in the high schools, if they choose to utilize that courtroom, once we get that facility stabilized and get it to where folks can use it, that's a place that they can use. They're currently using courtrooms that may be not, they haven't actually booked them. I think, am I understanding, is that the right term, that if there's a slot that a court is not on a day that they can use one of the courtrooms in the new courthouse, they go over there. But there's no reason why they couldn't just use that historic courtroom to do their mock trials rather than having to come in and out of the current courtroom. You know, so there's a lot of different options for the community that's available there with that historic courthouse. So I think if we kind of stay along those lines of what is the best use for the most citizens that building can be utilized, I think that should be our focus. And that's kind of the direction that we're moving in. And then once the restrooms are addressed, then we can begin to look at how we can improve that and some of the issues. Take those metal doors out, putting wooden doors back in there. You begin to really take it back to its historic where it was at originally, and it begins to really take on the flavor. If we can take a historic facility and modernize it
with modern features without changing the architecture of the building and trying to modernize the architecture that's in the building. That's what's been done in the past with the wooden, with the metal frame doors, openings, glass front, storefront type thing. That's what was done at that time, so.
We have a great opportunity. This thing, you know, gets kicked off big time. Is there a parking issue?
Well, I think anywhere you're at downtown, but.
Well, that's one of the things that besides the space available in the building itself, when you start looking at using that facility for the public defender, you didn't have enough space for the staff, much less the people that would come and go. You do have parking that is available within a short walking distance of that. The main parking, obviously, or I say the main, the closest parking is just on the street. But our facility, the judicial complex being catty cornered, the governmental building also being catty cornered, and then behind Steel Magnolias.
Yeah,
and then down across in front of the City Hall.
City Hall, and then you'll have First Baptist down there. All that part.
It's relatively close. It's not as close as probably some people would like, but based on some of the information we've been given, if, for instance, these tour groups pull up, they would come in and park probably in a parking lot if there's no space available on the street so that their customers can easily access the building and so forth. I would like to point out that the conference center authority that Commissioner Evans and I are on has recently hired a new director who actually, I believe, is on the job today, maybe. And I would think that he is going to have perhaps a high degree of enthusiasm for utilizing maybe that courthouse space for that visitor's area. And, hoping to be able to springboard off of that. If Commissioner Evans can just keep up with it.
Mary.
Who is this person?
Chris Hamilton. Commissioner Evans has described him as the Energizer Bunny, and I think that's probably
is he local?
He is as of today.
Where's he from?
He's originally from Kentucky. He's coming here from Galena, Illinois. So, if there's no more discussion on that, if you'd like to take a quick break, and then we're going to go back to rehashing some of these issues in a more vision-driven process.
I'd like to